here. I'm making some carnitas. Maybe I'll show y'all some pictures. I finished digitizing my race car photos, and I actually took my camera, an old video camera, that actually took a tape cassette, and it's one of them VHS-C cassettes, and brought it to the racetrack, the drag racetrack, when I had that big block Camaro. I think it was a 78 Z28, and I pulled a small block out of it and shit canned it. Put a big block Chevy in there with some pretty nice heads on it. Actually, I got the motor out of a pickup truck, the 454 pickup truck. It was an older one, and it had cracked heads on it. So I bought some decent heads. I found them used. I think they were actually the closed chamber heads, but they had bigger valves and ports than what the pickup truck heads had. They wasn't high perf heads. There's a bunch of different heads Chevrolet makes for big block Chevys. Back in the old school style, Mark IV gen engines. Pop needed. Pop. Dead soldier. Let me get a fresh one. Yeah, so anyway, I pull that motor out, that pickup truck in the Fobo main, and put studs. I studded the motor all the way around, if you know what that is. You hot rod guys would. And I wanted to run nitrous on it, which I did. So I put flat top pistons in it. And with those closed chamber heads, it made like 10.5 to 1, or 10.75 to 1 with those forged pistons. And we had that pickup truck in a Camaro, but the Z28 just had a 10 bolt rear end in it. We had that, it was a 3/4 ton Chevy pickup truck with a full floating GM 10.5 diff in the back with posit. So I said, man, let's stick this diff up under there. So we welded the perches on there for the springs off the old Camaro diff. Cut the perch pieces, remodified it, stuck that Chevy 3/4 ton diff up under it. And we had to mount, I think on a Camaro, the rear leaf springs are here, and the axle sits on top, the leaf spring in the back, rear axle. With that, we didn't have enough clearance to do that, so we actually had to put the axle underneath the leaf springs, which made the ass end stick up. But we put like, me and a good friend of mine, who's a mechanic also, he helped me assemble and stab the motor and turbo 400 that was beefed up. I actually rebuilt it, me and him, using TRW parts. TRW, no, TCI clutches and valve plates modifications and all kind of shit like that. We kind of po-boyed it at first, and ended up tearing up the gov lock that was in that that 10.5 diff. So a buddy of mine had a Detroit locker for it, so I put the Detroit locker in it, and that worked a whole lot better. And the reason I used that diff, because it had huge axles on it. The actual axle was huge. Welded a roll cage in it, put subframe connectors on it, welded those on, and the car would jerk the front end off the ground. It wouldn't stand straight up, but it had jerked the front end off the ground with those 12.5-inch slicks. And we got it into the low 12s at first, and we want to go faster than this, so we fooled around and put a nitrous kit on it. It was a 200 to 400 horsepower kit where you change the jets and mess around with it and get it back to timing off and do all kind of crap over. So we did all that and got it into the the 10s. And that was a lot of fun. I didn't want to blow the motor up. Sold the car before my kids started driving. But before I sold it, we put a 12 bolt in it with a spool, a full spool, with Moser axles, 33 spline Moser axles on that spool, and 411 gears. I think the truck had 411s also, and that worked out pretty good, because that with the cam setup that I put in the big block and intake and all, it's a 454. You know, so those you race car guys gonna know that that's a lower revving engine. You know, it's not a 427 that likes to rev because of stroke, etc. I was in the NHRA down here in the South. Had a lot of fun with it. We were running on race gas. I never did tube and tub it in the back. Left it like it was, and with the 12 bolt in it, it was okay. And it did a whole lot better than with that big truck rear end up under the back, because it made it sit up, fall funny. And battery was in the trunk, Lakewood traction bars. Y'all are probably gonna notice when that Camaro comes off the line in the video, I did something illegal to it. I actually made the rear diff solid. In other words, so the springs couldn't move. I took off the sway bar and the rear sway bar and attached those links to the shock mounts to where the rear diff couldn't go up or down. And with those big slicks on the back, they were like big balloon tires, and they come out the hole, but they pull the front end off the ground, both tires too, not just one, because of the subframe connectors. But the back end kind of poof, poof, poof. But it didn't lose any traction while it was hopping. It went. I think the 60-foot time on that car was, with that truck diff, it was like 1.2 seconds, 60-foot. It's badass, dude. When you come out the hole, you make damn sure you had your head against the backrest. And it had a 5-point harness in it, and race seat, and roll cage, all that shit. It felt like, when you come out the hole, it felt like somebody rear-ended you at 50 miles an hour. That's when it just, bam, and 60 feet. 1.2 seconds, kiddies. Think about that. How many horsepower? I don't know. I didn't have no kind of way to calculate that. At least 500. You know, running in the low 11s and the 10s, we were doing about, I think, 135. I don't. I can go pull the time slips, but I don't feel like going to dig for them. Boy, I know what else I wanted to add. That car still had the glass in it. We didn't put Lexan windows in it, but we cut all the metal out, took all the bumpers out of it, front and rear. Being it was a 78, it had that rubber stuff, so we had to reinforce it with some wood. I think on a rear bumper, I used a 1x6 and screwed some drywall screws in it to support the bumper to keep it from flapping around the rubber bra thing that it had front and back. And same way in the doors, I pulled out the impact bars that were in there. They were about 75 pounds a piece. Cut them out, and we had roll cage. I think it was a 6 or 8 point. I think I got a picture of it with the truck's mud grips on it too. The old 16-inch mud grips that, just for fun. Took it out on the road and smoked the piss out of them. So how you get something like that inspected? You go take the inspector for a ride in it. Pass. Nice car. Bring it back next year and take me for another ride. No problem, boy. Yeah, put a license on it. We drive race cars on the street down here in South Louisiana. Oh, hell yeah, boy. I do want to add, I painted that car my damn self under my carport. also found this, was talking about this in a past video, Louisiana Fish Fry Fry Products. It's their catalog where they've got all these things, and they sell all this down here. Look, seasoned fish fry, shrimp fry, hush puppy mix, all natural fish fry, except for the lard, seasoned chicken fry, chicken and fish bake, kind of like shake and bake, how about that? Brown gravy mix, cobbler mix, I used that in the past video. Can you see that, boy? Here's a bunch of them all pictured. You can buy them offline. Cajun gumbo mix, Cajun etouffee mix, jambalaya mix, red bean and rice mix, dirty rice mix, shrimp creole mix, barbecue shrimp mix. I usually like to go ahead and make my own from scratch. But if you don't know how to do that, you can buy this stuff. Cajun blackening seasoning, gumbo filet, which is almost impossible to find out of Louisiana, I know for a fact. Just Cajun seasoning, cayenne pepper, cocktail sauce, seafood sauce, hot sauce, tartar sauce, remoulade dressing. And look, there's another, their brand of Cajun injector, or injector. And they've got these gift boxes, any a ball and t-shirt, it's got a checklist on the front, how to ball seafood. So you can buy these gift baskets from them, and no, they're not paying me. I just know that this is a reputable company, and that's where I buy all my crawfish and seafood from when I'm up that way, because it's kind of out the way from South Baton Rouge. They're in North Baton Rouge. I don't think I mentioned, this is also, I did mention, this is Tony Seafood Deli in Fish Market, which you can Google it either way, and you can get to all this stuff here and order it and buy it. Look, they've got dinner mix box gift set, fry kit, marinade kit, fish fry aprons. I need to come up with some of this stuff and start selling it. Cajun gift box, Louisiana gift box. Okay, cool. They sold everywhere down here in grocery markets, grocery stores.